This is a lesson by bike. And we will see how a project of a cycle path can foster territorial regeneration. In order to understand this topic, let's see the project Trinto. The name Vento originates from the initials of these two cities, Venice and Turin. In Italian, Vento means wind. This reminds us softness and pleasure, but also the idea of a new green energy to explore the wonderful Italian landscapes. The project Vento was born at the Politecnico di Milano in 2010, when some of us started to imagine an alternative and sustainable way to regenerate fragile and scattered areas in Italy. But how can a cycle tourist path make it? Help us with four key points regarding a good cycle tourist path. 1. It has to be long, not less than 150 kilometers. It has nothing to do with the local and the urban scale. 2. It has to be safe, which means that this path needs to be paved and not shared with cars and trucks. This is a priority for cyclists. 3. It has to be continuous and easily accessible to everyone, especially for beginners. Cycle-tourism is not a competition, but an activity suitable for all ages, abilities and trainings. It's for all the people. 4. It has to be beautiful, both in terms of path and landscape. This kind of infrastructure is a new concept for the Italian context. On the contrary, in other countries, such as in Germany, Denmark, and in the Netherlands, cycle tourist paths have been designed following these criteria. This is the reason why those cycle tourist paths are crowded by thousands and thousands of travelers. For instance, in Germany, thanks to their 45,000 kilometers of long infrastructure, we count 175 million days spent by cycle tourists every year. It is as if every citizen in Germany spent 2 days per year cycling, newborns and 19 years olds included. We have much to learn from European experience. So, moving slowly by bike is important for the territory. Cycle tourists not only discover territories, but also at the same time, they can interact with both territory and local people. As a consequence, this gives the possibility to regenerate those areas from different point of view, economic, social and cultural. The economic impact of cycle tourism is very interesting and it's related with the so-called bike economy. Have you ever heard about it? Bike economy is about consuming local products, using local services, for instance, guest houses, B&B, inns, visiting the heritage, experience the territory. Cycle tourist paths generate income ranging from 100 to 300,000 euros per year for each kilometer of infrastructure. This unexpected income is really important for the activation of a social regeneration in local community based on new green jobs. This helps, for instance, stopping depopulation. Finally, this kind of tourism can promote cultural reactivation as well by moving slowly and over again through different landscapes and villages. Tourists can notice what is impossible to see by car or high-speed train, such as local parks, natural reserves, local and historical settlements, local cultural assets, local museum and tradition, handicraft, traditional foods, and so on. The regenerative vision is a crucial point of a project like Vento. Even if Vento is still a project at present time, in a few years it is going to be realized. In fact, even thanks to Politecnico di Milano effort, Vento has become a national priority in Italy. It has been included in the national system of tourist cycling path, as introduced in 2016 by the Italian government. Public funds, 1.8 million euros, have already been provided and more funds will come soon. Summarizing, Vento is in line with Agenda 2030 and the Sustainable Development Goals. In fact, we have seen how a project of a cycle path can become both an occasion to regenerate inner territories with a sustainable approach and a way to get in touch with local people. So, what are you waiting for? Take your bike next summer and make a world more sustainable.